Hello children, today we are going to do animal tissues. Alright, now animal tissues are like, you know, as we had said earlier, the tissues are like group of cells that are performing a certain function. Right, now for example, you know, like the skin, the hair, my nails, right, all of these are made up of tissues, right? So we are going to learn about them. And why just me? If you think of animals, you know, animals, they have horns, they have hooves, yes, eyes. So everything is actually made up of cells. So we are going to learn about those cells. Okay, what is their function, what purpose it is serving, and so on. Today we are going to do epithelial tissues. Okay, we are going to do epithelial tissues, which basically makes the skin, okay, or the outer surface of the skin, or for any organ if you take, like for example heart, then lungs, trachea, okay, the inner lining of that organ is formed of epithelial tissues. All right, now epithelial tissues are of many types. The first one that we are going to learn is the squamous epithelium. Now the squamous epithelial tissues are those that are present as the outer layer of my skin. Alright. Now what does it do? It protects the body from injury. Right? Let us see how it looks like. See how it looks like? They're very, very flat. Okay, they're very flat and they're very thin cells, and their cells are kind of irregular with a nucleus inside. Okay, so this is the nucleus and this is the cytoplasm. Now, do you see any intercellular space in between? No, these cells are very, very closely packed with no intercellular space almost. Alright, therefore there is no binding substance, they are just close to each other. How does it look like? It looks like the scales of a fish. Have you seen a fish? The scales of a fish, the squamous epithelial tissues look like the scales of a fish. Or for example, it looks like the tiles of a floor. You know, in the floor, the mosaic floor, the tiles are there. So this look like those tiles, right? And what did I say? What is the main function? Basically, you have to learn three things. Characteristics. What will come under characteristics? That they are very closely packed, they are very thin and flat, and they have no ground tissue. They are just connected by this basement membrane. Okay, they are just connected by this basement membrane. This basement membrane provides them the nourishment. Alright. Where are they found? Outer layer of the skin. What is the function? It protects the body from injury. Alright, three things you have to remember. Now, the same thing, if they are a little, you know, cuboidal in shape, they will be called as cuboidal epithelial tissues. Like for example, suppose it's like this. Children, these are actually the cells, right? Each of this is a cell, and they all together will be called as cuboidal or cubical, whichever is easy for you to remember, epithelial tissues. Now this cuboidal epithelial tissues, if you see, they are almost in the shape of a cube, right? And there any intercellular space in between? No. So in general, they have the same characteristics, no intercellular space in between, and they are together by this basement membrane. Thanks to this basement membrane, they are together, which is giving them the nourishment also. They have the nucleus, right? And they have very thin cell membrane. They are very thin cell membrane. There is no cell wall, children, because these are the animal tissues. You have to remember that. Okay, now where will you find them? You will find them on the inner lining of the bronchioles. Remember bronchioles in the lungs that we have studied? Okay, so it is present in the inner lining of the bronchioles. Now what is their function? Again, protection of the organs, right? From any kind of injury or any kind of friction and so on. So this is about the cubicle. Now if this same cells become long, it will look like this, right? It will look like this. So now they are called columnar epithelium. What are they called? Yes, they are called the columnar epithelium. Now in this columnar epithelium, can you already guess the characteristics? Yes, the cells are, you know, in the shape of the columns. And what else we find? The nucleus is near the bottom, generally near the bottom. Again, no intercellular space. In between there is no space left, okay? And the cell membranes are very thin. Now here there are certain hair-like projections, you know, very, very thin hair-like, which are called microvilli. Alright, they are called the microvilli. Now microvilli, if you remember, in digestive system, we have studied in the earlier class that in the small intestine, there are microvilli which is allowing absorption of food, right? They are absorbing the nutrients from the passing food. So this is the that microvilli. That means in the small intestine and in the large intestine, the inner layer cell is what kind of tissues? Columnar epithelial tissues. And what is their main function? Main function is absorption. Main function is absorption. Alright, so this is the third type. First was the squamous, second is cuticle, and the third is columnar. Now the fourth one, you will find it, you know, it is almost like this columnar only. Okay, they are also as, you know, like kind of long and elongated, and they have this basement membrane with which they are connected. But here, they have the hairs, okay. They have the 20 to 25 hairs on each cells. And what are these hairs called? They are called cilia. Right? So if you see inside your nose, you will find hairs. So these hairs are coming from what kind of cell? From these cells, which are called the ciliated epithelial cells. Ciliated epithelial cells. So what is the basic function of this cell canopy? Can you think of it? It is allowing the air to go inside in one direction, but is it allowing the dust particles also to go inside your lungs? No. So this cilia is kind of preventing the dust particles from going inside your lungs or inside your trachea. Okay. So this is the function of the ciliated epithelial tissues. And the last one is the glandular epithelial tissues. Glandular epithelial tissues, as the name suggests, glands, right? So they are present in the glands. And what do the glands do? They secrete, they give out some substance. Like for example, if I am talking about, you know, sebaceous gland, like my skin. You know, my skin is oily. That keeps my skin moist. Okay. So, it gives a certain texture to my skin. So, it is because of this glandular epithelium. So once again, we'll just revise. Today we did tissues, animal tissues, epithelial tissues we did, which is basically the outer lining of the skin or the inner lining of the organs in our body. Function, protection from infection, you know, like the cubicle epithelial. It actually protects the body from infection. Okay, it acts whenever there is inflammation in my body, right? And then there are certain cells which have the hairs. They are the ciliated epithelial that is present inside our nose. And then what does it do? It protects or it allows the air, or inside our trachea also it is present. It allows the air to go in one direction. And then you have first we did squamous. So squamous was protection. Next, second is the cubicle, which is protection against infection. And then columnar, which have the microvilli, remember? So columnar helps in absorption. And number fourth is the ciliated epithelium. Ciliated epithelium is passage of food or passage of air in one direction. And the last one is the glandular epithelium. Now, glandular epithelium is present in the inner lining of our mouth. Okay, so it is in the salivary gland. So salivary gland gives out saliva. So as I said, some give oil, some give saliva. Then there are certain which is giving out, you know, enzymes or hormones, like thyroid gland giving out thyroxine. So all these epithelial tissues have certain function to perform. Okay, hope you like it. Thank you.